My name is LaNada WarJack, and I was one of the 14 original students that took the island in 1969, and also the 89 students that came here and stayed for 19 months. I wanted to give you a message about the sun and the ceremony that we're doing right now. The sun is very powerful, and the non-Indian society, Western society, calls us sun worshippers. But what it is, this could be very powerful if all of you could turn and look towards the sun and hold your hands up. Your hands are receivers. And then we say our prayers to the sun, and what happens is voice travels on light. So I want you to say your prayers for all humanity, for the plants and the animals, for all life, because as that sun comes up and the earth turns, it will be received back to you and back into your hands. This is a very powerful moment and a very powerful time. And if we send those prayers out for peace on earth, for stopping the pipelines, for saving our Mother Earth and all of its inhabitants, just and your families and all the families of humankind, for the water, say the prayers for everything. This could be so powerful because, like I said, as the earth turns, it'll come back. And this is what life is waiting for. Now we have our other prayers, but it's kind of regional or right within the area. This is worldwide. This will go worldwide, and that's why it's so powerful. So the sun is coming up right now. I'm going to take a moment. I want you to just say your prayers. And it comes from your heart and your soul. It's positive, concentrated thought. And it comes out in voice and sound. And sound travels on light. And it'll come back to you. So I'm going to give you a moment. Grandmothers, grandfathers, ancestors, thank you. I want to thank you for bringing us all here together on this island to join in solidarity for all humankind and all the plant and the animal species, for the water, for everything that we have. Thank you for our families and our children. I ask that you help us so that we can be strong and to be able to empower ourselves to carry out what was meant to be, so that we continue the sacred circle of life. Bless us all. Bless all humanity. Take us into your warmth and bring us back stronger so that we can continue our resistance and our struggle for all life. Thank you. Thank you to all humankind. Amen.
Then take your hands and then pat yourself on your body like you would a smirk. And then you're bringing it back to yourself. So this is very powerful, and this is something that came from our ancient civilization at the time that we were more advanced than we are now. And this is something that can be so strong and so powerful with everybody's prayers, the strength of those prayers are necessary and needed. all life is waiting for that. So thank you, I wanna thank you. And I just wanna say briefly that when I came out on relocation back in 1965, I started at UC Berkeley. So my father always told us to get your education, come back and help the people. So if you have your cultural foundation and you know what it is, when you get your education, you've got both worlds and you learn how to live in those both of those worlds. So it's education is good as long as you keep your cultural foundation. And you do that through your prayers. And your prayers are your strength and it'll keep us going forever and ever. So I want to thank you for that. And I also want to thank the ITC for sponsoring this, keeping this going year after year. And all the people that have contributed to being here. When I started at Berkeley, it was a black group that helped me get in, the Mission Rebels, out of the Mission District. And we initiated the first Department of Ethnic Studies with the blacks, the Chicanos, the Asians, of course, the Native students, and all our white friends as well, the white students, because they were the population. So unity is with all of us. We need to unite, and that will make us very, very strong. Because it's going to take all of us to stop what's going on right now with the destruction of our earth and the plants and the animals. Because there are not too many of us, but we have to do our part and help in the best way that we can. So I want to thank you on this gorgeous day and remembering our ancestors who survived as long as they could to give us a new life. And so here we are today, and it's going to be our responsibility to carry this on and to carry on the sacred circle of life. So thank you.